game to round two, and dispelling the myth that Farfster can just base is basically a one-man stack, that's never happened. And again, the problem this time was coordinated engineering and a coordinated team defense. Red team by that final stage, even at that part of the game, they were doing fantastically well. Brunhagen had a fantastic sentry in place, and then what happened was the rest of the team were counter-attacking beyond the sentry. They didn't sit behind the sentry trying to fire from afar. They got in front of it, worn down everybody getting near the sentry, and the sentry finished everybody off. Also, the nice thing is, spies had no ability to get up there, and it's also indicative of one massive problem that blue team have. Get some freaking medics on your team! Stop just having one guy lump him in the job with Ubering somebody and then hope it'll work from there. You need more than one medic. Slight ferret rage there. We need more than one medic. Can we? No, no fire. Oh, jeez. It's not so much that either. You can't just rely on one person either. You have to have more medics. You've got to keep the pressure up. The point is, if you had one medic, the guy you want to Uber is the most competent, and also the guy who can reach. It'd be either a heavy or a soldier in this case. Maybe a demo man. Even that's tricky for a demo man, so Farfster was still the right choice, but you couldn't keep the pressure up. Oh, lovely work there from Desmond Unsupplied, saving a medic. And there's Farfster, getting away with murder, pretty much. Yeah, I can't believe nobody saw that Farfster up there. Well, no snipers were going for that, actually. Nice work from Burning Arrow, denying that sentry from being built. Denied. Yeah, you get a speed boost going through overclocked tellies now. You go a little bit faster, get into the action. And basically, they're really defending like a champ. All the M1. And, oh, look at Wheaties there. Navi work. And, what happened? There was some weird kind of laggy shit going on there. I smell mini sentry. There it is. That's actually a clock sentry, actually. That's what it looked like to me, Wheaties. And the sentry gets destroyed by the train, and there goes Base Squirrel again. Heavies really aren't paying attention to their surroundings right now. And there goes Sands once more. But blue team is running faster this time. They are doing a much better job here. And the crits, Doms are building up. Nice shot from Burning Arrow. He's really playing sentry denial today. Oh, wow. Tanked up and Burning Arrow kill each other at the same time. You both fire at the same time. You've got to remember, you're using projectiles. So what happens is that they will travel. There was you would like a hundredth of a second to do that. And it happened. Whoa, dear. I saw that crit rocket from here. And damn, Tony Tripp gets taken down. Unlucky there. Yeah, Captain, it's only for the overclocker. Modification of the Jag. Okay, this is looking interesting here. Very interesting. Ooh. Oh, geez. White Lightning there, having his work cut out for him. He's doing a fantastic job right now. Unfortunately, though, Base Squirrel and Tanked Up, I think that was Tanked Up. Yep. To be fair, that was a real fight in a box, that is. You had five. I'm sorry, how long do you have five for? To be fair though, five is still tied, so you still need six. So, the problem is, you still are only tied for the lead, so nobody's got the crown yet, because Base Squirrel had, Burning Arrow had four, Farfster's got, Burning Arrow's got five, Farfster's got five, and you had five. So, nothing really there yet. Yeah, as you know, we don't award tiebreakers here. No, I don't really do unboxings as such. I find it's a bit pointless activity. Like, look what I got, guys! I don't mind playing games, that's a different thing, but you know, unboxing like. Oh, Oh dear. Hang on, what's going on here? Oh, where did red team go? Suddenly the cops are looking a bit unprotected and faster. He's baiting everybody and doesn't see the one rogue engineer on the cart. And that's the second point taken. Oh, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And Faster's on 6. Okay, so he's got the crown back. Now, 7 minutes on the clock here. And, are you serious? Did you try and build a level 1 sentry in front of blue team spawn? And Maximus there, oh, he tried to hide. That was not going to work. Oh, sorry, no. Being friendly doesn't count in this server. Get slaughtered. I institute a policy of no prisoners here. Oh, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and Samus Aran has 6, the guy who's healing fast though, so I'm afraid it's deadlocked again. Oh wait, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, faster and Samus has 7, the tiebreaker keeps going. No, you don't have 8, you don't have 8 just yet. Oh dear. Now blue team's trying to move off on through, they're going to need to use all the sides they can get. Okay, so let's see what's going on around here. Just gonna check out if it actually. Whoa, where'd that go? Ali there, nice reflex from base scroll, but quite a few reflex going on here. Calm the hell down. Oh, that's a sentry up there. Barth is trying to get to it. Oh, we got sapped. Oh no, ball 30. Run for. Oh, fuck. Oh no! Takes down Tony Tripp. That side is going down though. Base score though, ever vigilant. Ever Batman. Now, the thing is, I have a bad feeling here that we're not going to see first point for the entire commentary. We've got 20 minutes left of this commentary anyway. Also, I need to do something. Is that all the tar? I'll accept that. Random quest. A-U-T. Oh. Also, I have noticed one thing. Why is Autark not on my friends list anymore? At 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that's fast though. So yeah, that is Autark, to be in all honesty. So yes. To be fair though, the scrambles have been randomised. I can't blame him. That's where the scrambles come out. But in any case though, they are still losing. I mean, the game is perfectly balanced. I mean, look at blue team, they're pushing quite nicely. And there we go. Okay, blue team's still in the game. I thought they were going to lose out there, but somehow they just broke through. And look at that cart. That cart is on the move, though. Basically, we're struggling to save that cart this time. He's really got no best with him. There's Fast, though, finally. Now, remember, to use Demo Knights. Autark does not like Demo Knights. He can't run away from them. Oh, whoa. Where'd that pyro go? I don't... Robin there gets sent to the atmosphere. Sans, I bless your connection. Sudden and instant disconnection happens. Nah, I already bless your connection. You're just gonna stop being poor and get a better PC. Now, in any case, let's get back to this game and see what's happening here. Well, oh my god. Oh my no! Both in the struggle of a lifetime. God, who's gonna win this? Is Balther is just struggling so hard. Oh, he gets taken out after all that, but I couldn't believe. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ortok now tied with Faust on 8. But Barth's trying to keep his teleporter alive despite that demon man trying to beat it at the other end. Oh god, that was hilarious. And looks like the blue team is going to move up. We are going to see last point. Ooh, nice work there. Windows 95? No, Bron Argon. Ooh, you're off. Okay, here we go. Nice work, Tony Tripp. Gets over the line. And... okay. Now we are going to see last point. Now, is blue team going to get sentries? Are they going to get teleporters in place? Are they going to get spies in the right areas? Ali, man. Nice stab, but I think you should have gone for the teleporters. We don't know where that thing's going. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. That is a problem. The problem is also as well, that teleport is a little bit counterproductive because now people keep using the teleporter and keep getting sent to the wrong part of the front. And now blue team is just pushing this easily because red team is getting too sent so far somewhere else. And Barth got disconnected! No! Oh, jeez. So, oh dear. Oh dear. Now, 8 minutes 42 and red team are about holding here. Fast is pretty much the only line of defense right now. Red team is kind of a bit spread out. And Death of the Moon Empire kills off the last of people. And Samus... well, Ortok there killed off and destroyed by Desmond the Moon Senpai. Who puts a telly there? And the incoherent rage is back. Oh, we missed you, Ortok. Oh yeah, Maximus is a modded server, by the way, so yeah, the Hulong heater now makes you fly. If you fall on somebody, it is almost instant kill, though, so that is really quite fun. Now for the moment though, where is blue team? Why aren't you guys moving up? Get to the front! Blue team's all over the shop again. There's Fluxy, who just joined. And Maximus there trying to get a stomp in. Oh, taken out. Lovely shot there from Sans. There goes Desmond. Nice. Why is Desmond the hardest working kitten on blue team, to be fair? It just seems he's the only one going for the cart. Get on cart, damn it! You're all around it, but not actually on it. Benny boy, I've not seen him in ages. Hello, Benny boy. Haven't seen you in a long time. Oh, fire. No, it's not. Nine. He is not in the lead. He had 4. Oh wait, he does have 9, doesn't he? Yeah, he did overtake. He overtook Fast though, didn't he? Well, I think he had 8, to be fair. Did he have 9? Yeah, 8-8. Yeah. Tied at 8. He didn't have 9. I'm sorry, son. I didn't see it. No. Geez. Can you actually play the game rather than keep chatting at the commentator? Any case, let's keep going. Now, any case, there's not Robin there. There's not Shadow anymore. And 5-6 minutes on the clock, and blue team says there's a chance to win here, but we're just not seeing very focused at the moment. They're kind of going everywhere. And Desmond, you have an Uber, why are you shooting the sky? This is not a productive use of Uber. Oh dear, that was not the best use of Uber there. And Scootaloops gets horribly destroyed by a rampaging Demo Knight. And I'm sensing some swears coming from the end of the monitor. I didn't expect to be Ubered. Five minutes 22, and Blue Team needs to get their act together. We got a lot of... Oh, hang on. There's Sands actually keeping the cart in line. Now, Blue Team has now got guys teleported to the front and whatnot, but they're just not paying attention or getting there fast enough. Oh, lovely stomp from Maximus. Bronagon gets stomped out there. Unsuspecting sniper. Don't know. We've got 12 minutes left, though. Lovely roof and burning arrow there. Oh, the cart is getting there. Sort of. Now, okay, Wheaties is making... Oh, look at him go. Oh, look, there's a surprise sentry there. That's now gone now. Okay. But Sam's on the cart. Base we're trying to protect. Oh, no. And Wheaties on the cart there. He is surviving. No, Shadow, no! And we're seeing a lot of desperation here. 4 minutes left in the cart, and Red Team have got to... Desmond right now is moving right up to Red Spawn and just spawn camping like a champ at the moment. But he's trying his best. He's trying to kill off the entire Red Team. And he's on the cart. Oh, there he gets stomped a little, and... Uh-oh, hang on. What's the spook there? Scootaloop's there trying to just hold it. No, he's in the pit. No, Uber can't save you now. And I think Blue Team making their way towards the cart. Just, oh dear, 3 minutes 33. And, oh, Robin wins it. Nicely done. Okay, game 2, round 3, because apparently, you know, both teams now won, and it's like, yeah, interestingly, did we have a scramble? No, we didn't. Any case, though, we have another 10 minutes left, we'll make this last round, shall we? Okay, now what I'm saying about that game, I don't know what it is, we aren't seeing very committed blue teams today. They kind of seem to wobble around a bit and tend to get near the point, but not actually doing it with it, if you know what I mean. Would Blue Team be likely to go all heavy at any point? I mean, that would be funny. I mean, seriously, heavy rushes are kind of fun to do, to be fair. I mean, if you can, like, pull one of those off, they just go fast. It's like, you know, you got all these heavies on the cart, and everything just gets destroyed to oblivion. Now, let's see how... Five minutes 45. Oh dear, and cart is kind of stuck in the door there. Speed is on the cart, but not actually on the bit that you need to be capping it with. And there he goes. Shadow's on the cart, getting pushed. Nicely done, but where is Blue Team? I'm sorry that we are seeing a few guys in spawn. Ali, Fasto, and Maximus. There's a lot of AF carry going on right now. Yeah, we actually have a problem because three members of Blue Team are seemingly AFK right now. Yeah, Ali, man, if you're there, you do need to be doing something. I know you do need a BRB, but this is getting really... I think Fast is probably going to toilet. But it's like Blue Team, like three men down at the moment. And this is a really bad time for everybody to start going. Now, any case, Shadow 5-2 is on the cart. Thing is that they're going to try and do the best they can with the resources they have at the moment. Nice work there, Captain Fluffy. Can he stay on the cart, though? Gonna be honest, for the two guys stuck in spawn who just are staying in there, this is getting a little tiring, okay? There's a blue team that is moving up quite nicely. Could be the blue team will win this despite two people being AFK, but I will give them the benefit of the doubt a little bit more. But they can't just keep being AFK continually. Now, in any case, 3 minutes 35. Blue team, though, is nearing a possible victory with this game, though. They're not entirely lost just yet. That cut is on the move, though. Thanks up though, nice work getting rid of that sentry and his engineer. And there we go, okay. Blue team are close. Can they keep this going though? The thing is right now they need more guys getting to the point. Yeah, I'm sorry, but this is going to get ridiculous. They've got too many guys just sitting in spawn right now. Okay, let me deal with this. Let's have a look. The Cobra has stopped. Go, go, go! Charge! There we go, okay. I hate kicking people, but the problem is, though, like, two of them at the same time just taking an extended period of leave. It's like, you can't just sit there and, like, BRB it forever. You know, if you're going to the toilet, that's fine. If you're going to take a dump, it's unfortunate. If you're going to do homework, on the other hand, like, no! Like, one thing or the other, you can't just basically do want both things at the same time. The other people might want to get in. I know it's a bit Skyle-like to do that, but at the same time, though, it's like too many guys on the same team are going long-term AFK. I'll give Faster the benefit of the doubt because, you know, he plays and he contributes a lot, so, you know. And I trust Faster. He's a long-time member, pillar of the community, so yeah, I trust him when he says BRB. In any case, getting back to the game, and... No, they didn't change it, that's what I was going to say. Bernargon there trying to survive, but I think Blue Team might just grab it here. Can they grab this cut though? Blue Team, 1 minute left. Are you gonna get this cut pushed though? It's looking good. Looking very good. Wheaties there trying to stop it, but no, you can't do it while invulnerable, and Blue Team get the new location. Okay, looks like Blue Team has a new lease of life. Blue team's now coming back round the corner again. It's looking good. And there's Shadow. Nice. Oh, and it looks like Sand, I think, this rage quit or something or other. And it looks like Shadow's having a bit of a problem trying to push the hold up. Oh, there we go. Okay. I wasn't sure what happened there, but it looked like Shadow was... Oh, was he being quick-fixed? Oh, that's why. It got quick-fixed in the cart. Cart wouldn't move. There aren't random crits in the server. But in any case, though, look at Blue Team. They're really flying now. Also, what Clown is up to? Deep operations, I guess. And Red Team right now are trying to exact vengeance on all spies right now. Now Blue Team, they have a new spawn. Do they have a new spawn door? I think they do, don't they? Yes, they do. Now, they've maintained the momentum in this game. They are still pushing quite nicely. Nice to have you back, Ali. Unfortunately, he gets massacred there. And okay, there we go. Right. Okay. One thing I'm saying though, Shadow52 doing a fantastic job of actually trying to achieve the objective. This is why you need at least one heavyman. Because they really work for just generally clearing out entire areas. And right now, red and blue team are getting mixed in here. You know, no real front line at the moment. Ooh, Diamondback. I think they play Deus Ex. I keep forgetting to do that. Gonna be honest though, Deus Ex are really hard bastards to run. My piece is getting too old now. Although it did fantastic service in its time. Basically, my piece is that kind of Ben Kenobi. Like, back in the day, it was ace. And nowadays, it's just a bit old now. But still, it can still run things to the best of them. It's a good PC. Take on the cut. And on. Oh, take down Bron Argon Sentry. Now, this is the thing, though. Intelligent heavy work there, using a medium range minigun to take out a medium range sentry. Lovely work there. But also, to be fair, the rest of the red team wasn't there to support. Thing is, right now, though, blue team needs to push in. We're seeing that familiar problem again of people not being really at the front or dying too quickly. We do maybe need is at least one engineer, just one, and make a teleport in that one-way gate area. There's a nice little upwards area, a little rampy bit. If you put that one there, people can jump over the side, over the railings to get straight to the front, or they can go around and behind, or they can use the one-way door. But it's a lovely area for. I'm sorry, but Benny Boy's fine. It's just one of those things. I mean, I'm not going to start persecuting people for being AFKs. I only play AFK for a significant amount of time. That's the thing. And so, you know, we're not going to call out AFK straight away here. Now, any case. Bron Argon's got sentry back. This is terrible. Shadow's right there again. And the rest of. Where is blue team? Coagulate, will you guys? And we're seeing the familiar defense again. Red team has got a fantastic defense. Bron Argon's sentry's in place. And where is team is the new catchphrase here. Because just where is blue team? They're scattered. Benny Boy makes an appearance. An unlucky faster. Desmond just moves in like a champ. And Tony Tripp gets a lovely, lovely combo up there. But what happens? There's nobody's there. Where is team? Nice work. Okay, now to be fair though, Tony Tripp got a bit of a saving grace there because his teleporter is still active. Now, if he can make that go to level 3, that will get guys to the front line a lot quicker, and he needs to do it ASAP. You get that teleport up and running fast as possible. Guards will get to your location, which means they'll hold your location a lot better, and your then team will push. And look at that sentry go down. The engineering theory is always solid. Get your guys to the front line, keep the pressure up, and it works beautifully. Speaking of engineering, a lovely sentry there from what is it, Wheaties. That is an absolute asshat sentry. Lovely location. Unlucky Benny Boy did not see the sentry. Now that's the thing, if you want to get rid of that sentry, Benny Boy's location is good. If you hide behind those logs and crouch, you can fire over it using a demo mat and easily clobber that sentry. Now you just simply sap it, and he loses the sentry, but he keeps the sentry. Nicely done there, clown. And there goes fast though. Has he seen the sentry? No, he hasn't. He kind of ran out just before he could do anything. But 4:35. Blue team can still win this, but this is going to be an awkward fight. It's like fighting on a toilet. Again, trying again though, this is getting quite tricky in places. Oh no, Wheaties, why? That was a terrible decision. Sentry is now in the open. That was arguably the worst decision in the entire commentary. Excellent sentry location. It was fine. Then he got moved somewhere open and where as a one-way guy at long range could take it out. That was not the best place to move a sentry. And that may just give Blue Team the area. Sometimes keeping a sentry in the right place is contributing more than moving it somewhere it's actively firing. Because if your team knows that an area is covered, then it's always so. And now Farso's right there. It's not looking good. Thing is, having that sentry there meant Red Team could sit back and relax because they know they didn't have to overly defend those angles. Unfortunately, by moving it and trying to keep it to firing range, it wasn't covering that area and putting an area that was much less suited to it. And right now, Farso's moving up. The rest of the team needs to get involved on this. Come on, Blue Team, get out there. Okay, Cart is going around the corner, 3 minutes on the clock. Is Red Team going to be able to hold this, though? This is the decider here. You can start the comm now. Fucking get on it! Get your ass on the god damn it! Okay, right. Blue also has two medics on their team. This is a lot better than last time, to be fair. Okay, look. Oh, yes. Individual on the cart. It's looking good. Lovely step from Ali, though. And who is this? Didn't expect a sentry there. But, oh, dear. Shadow 5-2 there. Getting a little bit of clobbers in. Just didn't know about the new sentry. Oh, and Pushkin the cart. Nice achievement. Thing is, though, 2 minutes on the clock, and the cart is close. This is going to be a nail biter of a finish here, and Wheaties sentry is back in action. It's working again. Oh, what is this? Farson tries to get in there, but one dogged pyro stops it from happening, and that cart is so close! And Red Team needs to stay on the cart. Oh god! Red Team needs to stay on the cart the entire time. You cannot get off it. 1 minute 30. What the fuck is... And Kev do 70 there is on the cart right now. Red Team is like... Holy fuck bollocks. And yes, Faster grabs it! Faster grabs it on one man. Red Team, you forgot to stand on cart. Oh my god, the salt. The absolute salt draining out of Faster's paws right now. And he caps the cart after all that. Oh god. 5 minutes extra on the clock here, and Blue Team is running on the power of salt right now. Blue Team has their new spawn doors. This should be a lot easier for them to get to the front now and choose a direction to attack from, but oh dear. But they've got to. The thing is, Blue Team can't rest again. They've got to keep pushing. Salt train. Now remember, Blue Team, you've got other angles, and Faster is using them immediately. That little right-hand flank has opened up now. That one-way door is now open. You can use it to get around and go straight for Red's spawn area. I mean, you get one heavy in there. Sit in the spawn door areas and just keep shooting people as they come out and hope the rest of your team pushes up. Oh, nice work there. Yes, lovely work there, Clown. Take down those... Saps those sentries. Shadow 5-2 on the cart, and Red Team's keeping an eye on it though, but Blue Team got a lot bigger front to use. Remember, flank right if you can. Are you guys even flanking? Are you all going to the left? Why you no use special doors? Oh, this is painful to watch. Like, Clown, turn around, Clown. Nope, okay. Oh, jeez. Nobody's using the flank door at all. Like, why? Okay, okay. Look at this. Look, finally, we've got Fasto, Kev, Samus. Why is it all the good players using the flank routes? This shouldn't be something that requires a skill level to do, which is navigate a map. Lovely stab from Liash there, and Kart is now on the last stretch. Go through the special doors! Shadow 5-2 there, special heavy operations there. And Kev 270 clobbering medics as is tradition. And look at this go, tanked up on the cart, it's looking good. Oh boy, special doors. Nice, but blush it. Okay, now blue team. This is what I'm saying. Use the special magical flank doors, which gets you to the point faster. Speed, distance, time. These are all related. Use the shorter route to save time. Get to the point faster. Now, in any case, 2 minutes 53 and blue team look for a win here. Can they push over? Are Red going to hold up? Tanked up's on the point. It's looking good. Burning Arrow jumps down on the cart there and it gets knocked off. Can Red Team hold it? They need to stay on. Oh dear God, they have to stand on the cart. Why is it you guys never stand on the cart when I tell you to stand on the cart? And then something goes horribly wrong. Oh jeez. I never thought I'd see Spooker Krumo accidentally Uber a spy, then kills the other heavy on the cart. Stand on the cart, so three guys stand on the cart, one was a spy. Best acting EU. Yeah, we'll stand on the cart. We need Uber. Uber spy. A spy immediately stabs the other heavy before he can change target. Oh my god, that was so funny. Also, Desmond, standing on the top bit isn't standing on the cart. They get underneath you, they will push it. But oh god, that was pure gold. And don't worry, Clown, it was caught on tape. And uh-oh. Oh, God, Shadow's... Oh, no! Oh, God! Oh, God, Shadow 5-2. Wombles in there, but the entire Red Team decided to be Ubered at once. Oh, God, why is it... Stop. 1 minute 20, and the cart is rolling back. Red Team are getting precious, precious... Oh, points here. Oh, dear God, this game is going everywhere. Kev, what happened? Jeez, this is... Oh, jeez. Lovely stab there from Clown. Get Spookaloops after all that. Oh, my God. This point is so... Oh, Shadow 5-2 gets on the cart, gets stabbed after all of that. And Captain Fluffy on the cart, can you do it? No! Oh, my God, 40 seconds left. Is the pub push happening? Lovely stab from Liash there. Red Team are just sitting on the thing. This is advanced ferret tactics here of actually standing on the cart. The butt clench is real. Oh, unlucky Clown. Oh, lovely stab though. What a way to, you know, make the best of a bad situation. 15 seconds left. Is Blue Team gonna... Oh God, Shadow's in there. Can he make it work? Oh, come on, come on! Oh God, can it happen? 4 seconds left! Battle for the cart is now! Are they gonna win this? Blue Team takes it right at the very end! Oh my God, what a way to take a game! Oh jeez! Oh God, this is the best experience I've ever had in a pub. Oh God, I'm afraid that's what I'm doing for today, I'm afraid. Anyway, guys, that's all the time I have for today, but thank you very much for turning up, and what a last round. That was amazing. The clench, all the clench going on there, and that's kind of why I like the last point of this particular map. But yeah, anyway, congratulations, but nobody actually got to 9 DOMs, so nobody gets the crown for today. Faster still is online for 9 DOMs for the throne, though. So he still has his throne. Mission begins in 10 seconds. Goddamn, Fasto, calm down, man. Calm down. They got it in the end, don't worry. But in any case, though, for those of you who want to play more of this stuff, my name is TF2 Public Ferret. This is a TF2type.com project beta. This is a modded server. If you want to do more of this stuff, please feel free to join my Steam group called TF2 Public Ferret. And also join Tightrope's TF2 Tightrope Steam group, as well as get more event updates for this. If you can basically join my Steam group, there's the overview page. It has all the dates and times, whatever you need, what I'm doing, which server, what the IP addresses are, and have announcements say what's going on in the week. So keep an eye on those. If you want to see this again, though, please join my YouTube channel, TF2 Public Ferret. That's it. That's my YouTube channel, and I have a Twitch as well, which you've been Twitched on actually, and we had nobody watching. TF2 Public Ferret. So I hope you guys had a fun time today, because I definitely did. That last point was so clench, it was just ass-achingly good. Any case, though, guys, thank you very much. I had a really fun day today, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!